How did Michael Faraday make electricity with magnets? And hey, how does anyone make electricity with magnets? And what does that have to do with the creation of the idea of magnetic fields? Watch this short video and find out. Ready? Let's go.
Electricity.
In 1826, an English scientist named Michael Faraday had read that another Englishman named William Sturgeon had made a pretty strong magnet by wrapping wire around an iron bar and putting current in the wires. Sturgeon had used bare wire and the iron was coated in lacquer. Because of this, Sturgeon had to be careful that the wires didn't touch or the electricity would just short circuit across the wires instead of going through the wires. Faraday had a little 6-inch iron ring that wasn't coated. He decided to wrap the wires with cloth to insulate them instead of coating the iron. In this way, he could wrap the wires very close together and make a much stronger electromagnet. Because his iron was a ring, Faraday wrapped two separate coils, one on the left and one on the right. It looks like a strange artifact from a mummy's crypt. Faraday used to keep this ring in his pocket while he did other research. He was sure it would be useful somehow, he just didn't know how. Then on July 4th, 1831, Faraday took a professional risk. He quit his government research job that he hated and decided to branch out on his own. What Faraday wanted to do was study electricity and magnetism. Specifically, Faraday was determined to create electricity with a magnet. After all, it had been 11 years since a Danish man named Hans Oersted had shown that electricity pushes magnets. It seemed logical that magnets must affect electricity too. For many years, Faraday had been tinkering with magnets and wires, but to no avail. He wondered if maybe the magnet wasn't strong enough. For that reason, he took the little ring out of his pocket. He decided to use one side of the ring as his magnet and the other side as his tester to see if he could create current without directly connecting it to a battery. He put a compass under the tester wire to see if it had any current. When Faraday connected a battery to the first coil, an amazing thing happened. The magnet next to the second coil twitched, then nothing. When he cut off the current, the magnet twitched again, in the other direction, then nothing again. Faraday repeated this experiment multiple times and found that he created current in the second wire when the first one was charging up or discharging, but never when it was flowing steadily, even when it had an incredibly large current. In other words, an electromagnet only creates current when the magnet was changing. If the strength is steady, nothing happens. Faraday wrote to a friend, quote, I'm busy just now again on electromagnetism, and I think I've got a hold of a good thing, but I can't say. It may be a weed instead of a fish that after all my labor, I may last pull up. Faraday had managed to use electricity to create electricity, but he still hadn't managed to use magnets to create electricity. After several attempts that were mostly too subtle to be observed, Faraday pushed a very strong magnet into a coil of wire and retrieved it again. When the magnet was moving, the compass moved too. Here was the fish that Faraday was hoping to catch. He had briefly created electricity with a magnet in motion. Faraday had another device at his disposal. The Royal Institute where he worked had a giant magnet, actually 437 magnets stuck together, that Faraday could play with. Moving the coil towards and away from this rod created a very strong current. However, he couldn't detect a current even from this incredibly strong magnet when it was still. This validated his previous results. Moving magnets in a coil of wire creates current, but constant magnets, no matter how strong, do not create a current. Faraday's discoveries were revolutionary, but his theories of why they happened were just as radical. For centuries, people had noticed that if you sprinkle iron filings around a bar magnet, it creates patterns. In his paper, Faraday said that the iron filings were lining up with the, quote, lines of magnetic forces. Faraday felt that these magnetic field lines were always present around magnets and around current-carrying wires. The iron filings just made them visible. In this way, Faraday invented the idea of magnetic fields. Faraday decided that current is created or induced when the lines of force are broken or cut by a coil of wire. Think about pushing the bar magnet above into a coil of wire. As you push the magnet, imagine the magnetic field lines passing through the coil. Faraday felt it was this disturbance of the force, not to get too Star Wars about it, that created the current in the coil. As strange as it seems, this is the theory we still believe today. Faraday realized that the current he had produced was in spurts. He wondered if he could use magnets to make continuous electricity like a battery does. In this quest, he was inspired by something called Arago's wheel. See, 9 years earlier, a Frenchman named Arago had noticed that if a copper disc was rotated near a compass magnet, the compass magnet would turn. Faraday decided that it worked because turning the wheel moved parts of the disc closer and further from the magnet, which created current in the disc. The current then pushed the original magnet. Faraday tested his hypothesis using the giant magnet at his disposal. He spun a copper disc near the magnet and then connected parts of the disc with wire. He placed the compass near the wire to detect if it was creating current. When he turned the wheel, the needle turned and stayed constant. Faraday had used motion to create a steady current. He had also invented the first electric generator. Faraday's results were astonishing. The scientific community was especially impressed with him for solving the mystery of Arago's wheel. Faraday himself felt particularly satisfied to have succeeded without using math, a subject he didn't know. It was so popular that the Prime Minister dropped by the laboratory to see Faraday's generator firsthand. When he asked Faraday about its uses, Faraday supposedly replied, quote, "I know not, but I wager one day your government will tax it." That's a bet he would have won. Although the generator that Faraday made was impressive for demonstrations, the current would make strange patterns in the disc, called eddy currents, that would keep it from producing large currents, large useful currents. In fact, it would take another 30 years before a cast of characters managed to make a useful electric generator. And that story is next time on The Secret History of Electricity.
Electricity, electricity.